Here is the band from the Macedonia Middle School. Macedonia Middle School is?
Where's that?
You know where Macedonia is?
Well?
Macedonia is just up on the other side of Monk's Corner. If you went up Highway 17A and headed right on up like you were going to Georgetown, alternate 17, you'll go right into Macedonia, just a little ways past Monk's Corner.
Sounds biblical.
It does, doesn't it?
Yeah. Yes, it does.
So these kids have come a long way here. Here is the float from the Beaufort County Water Festival. You know, they have a beautiful festival down in Beaufort every
year. Yes, they do.
Right there in the harbor. I haven't been down there in several years, but every time I have been, they put on a beautiful festival.
Look at that pretty blue.
Absolutely. Isn't it beautiful? They've got their beautiful little outfits on this morning.
Nautical.
Yeah.
Is that Ronald McDonald behind there?
Right in behind here? Yeah, look at there.
Ronald McDonald,
I believe, yeah. Over there on the side of that float.
I just might add that Carla Taylor, who is their publicity chairman with McDonald's, has been wonderful in helping us with publicity for the Flower Town Festival. She got little flyers printed up and put it in every sack that went out at McDonald's and in every tray.
I think that's somebody imposter.
Oh, it's not Ronald McDonald.
No,
he's coming later, though. I know he's going to be here.
Yeah, well, that's somebody trying to fool us, I believe.
Well, he's got red hair.
That was a float from a Miles Road Baptist Church.
This must be their clown ministry. Hi.
Got to be. Hello. Good morning. Happy smiles on their face this morning. Boy, how can you help but be happy when you've got a parade going in front of you on a beautiful day? Oh, boy. Right in behind them is a float from Save More Foods.
And right after the parade is when all the big fireworks happen with all the arts and crafts.
Yeah. I hear some music coming and our camera will pick it up in a moment. Sounds like Clarkin music to me. Just as I go to talk, they're going to clog for us.
Oh, good.
They're going to get off the float and give us a little clogging demonstration
Yay.
This morning. Yeah, all right. Boy, look at those pretty outfits they've got.
They're lining up just for you, Dan.
Aren't they cute? Look at them. Do you clog? You ever clogged before?
Oh, yes.
Have you?
Sure.
Never done it.
Sure.
But I love to watch.
I taught dance.
I love to watch you.
So I like all dances.
Well, it stops as soon as it starts, you know, just as quick.
I guess
it's time to move on.
Time to go. Bye-bye.
Move on. Bye-bye. We enjoyed that.
The country cloggers.
Yes, sir. They are good.
Ooh,
they are good.
Long, blonde, pretty hair. Country cloggers. Yeah, dancing's a lot of fun, Dan.
I enjoy dancing. I just can't clog.
Okay.
I'm a little too old for that, I think.
You dance to the music.
We want to get up here. We should have got up here on top of the table here and clogged a little bit while the cloggers were going. Hey, here he comes,
there
the
he
real
is.
Thing. Yes, sir.
Ronald.
There is Ronald McDonald, the real thing from McDonald's.
There's Carla Taylor driving that truck.
Yeah, there's Carla in the truck.
Yeah.
There. And right in behind, look at here. Here comes Mr. McGruff, the crime-fighting dog. I got you. Distinctly heard him say, take a bite out of crime.
Oh.
All right, from the Courtney Middle School in Charleston, the Courtney Middle School High School Band. Edmund Knight. Should I say old Edmund Knight? That's Edmund Knight. Let's put it that way. Edmund's in the parade every year, and he's always riding his bicycle or driving an old car in the parade. Without Edmund Knight, it just wouldn't be a parade. Well, big hand for the Courtney Middle School Band from Charleston. Well, I'll tell you, I want to congratulate Ricky Waring and the group for lining up so many bands this year. You know?
Yes.
Love those bands. Everybody loves the parade and bands just seem to add so much to it. They really do. Well, from the Somerville YMCA, you know these folks, don't you?
Sure, I know these folks.
Here's a floating, a big 18-wheeler.
The festival, the Flower Town Festival, the proceeds go to help the YMCA.
Absolutely.
Hopefully, we're going to be able to build a new facility because the town is growing so much. And it's really saturated the existing facility. So hopefully with all these, with all the money from the proceeds, we'll be able to build a new YMCA. We need it.
Well, I've said for 16 years now, the money has gone toward the YMCA. And that's how this parade, really all the festival and parade all got started, was to raise funds for the YMCA and for the community. And it's still continuing 16 years later, and it gets bigger and it gets better every year. And like you say, I talked to Mike Parson the other day, who's a YMCA director and festival chairman this year, and he echoed exactly what you just said. Hopefully, they can raise enough funds to build a new facility. And it is so, so needed in the area.
They've got plans for a new swimming pool and new lights on the courts and a nice big facility.
Yes, sir. Well, of course, this festival parade is just part of the festival. Boy, the arts and craft going on down in Azalea Park, all of the other events down there, the Children's Festival, the
Taste
of Somerville, hot air balloons, so much going on in Somerville on this weekend. From our radio stations in the area, 95SX, that's where you hear the music in the background coming from. I see one of the members of the crowd across the way was hollering for him to turn the music up louder.
We've also had a lot of help with our publicity from Charleston Lithographing. I'd like to thank Lloyd Lean for all the publicity that he did for us. All of our printing he did for us at cost. So all these beautiful Flower Town Festival posters that you've been seeing around,
right,
we'll have Charleston Lithographing to thank for that.
Absolutely. They are beautiful. By the way, those posters, I think, are going to be available down in the park or somewhere for sale?
On Main Street.
On
if
Main
you just
Street?
Go down Main Street, you'll see them. They're framed. They're sitting on an easel. You can buy them for $10. And they're only 250 of the colored ones. And they're numbered and signed. You can get the artist to sign them if you'll go by and see Charles C. Bulwick at her booth in the Arts and Crafts Festival.
Duper duper.
My husband did the other one. And you can come to the Philip Pennington Fellowship Concert tonight at 7 o'clock, and he'll be glad to sign that one for you.
Well, we've got some beauty queens on here. Jeannie Hayes, Tri-County Teen Miss. We've also got Shannon Walker, Junior Miss, Tri-County 1988. Young Baby Miss South Carolina, and Little Baby Miss. All on that float right there, sponsored by the Fox and Hounds Restaurant. Now, I want you to look coming up just to the left when you get a chance, right behind you. You're going to see one of the biggest boats I've ever, one of the biggest outboard boats that I've ever seen in my life. My goodness, wait till you see this thing. It is one huge boat. You enjoying the parade here, Sonny?
Yes, I am.
Couldn't have a better view for it.
That's
for the parade here on this beautiful day. Absolutely. Hello, everybody. We're glad to have you along with us here as we view this 1988 Flower Town Festival parade on a gorgeous day here in downtown Somerville. It is beautiful. If you're not down here or didn't, if you're watching it on television and didn't get a chance to come down Saturday morning, you missed a lot of excitement, believe you me. You really
That's
did.
Beautiful.
You really did. The music you hear in the background and all the dancing going on out there, that's the float from the wave.
Maybe
still...
that big boat made this wave.
They have. Well, it kind of makes you want to get up and dance, doesn't it? He's dancing. Look at him. He's having a good time. Up on his top of shoulders. Dancing away the morning.
Catch me now a bully. Catch me now a bully. Catch me a bully. Catch me now a bully.
Exactly where the Wave nightclub is, Sonny, but I'm going to find out. I like this. Yes, sir. Look at him. Got everybody dancing. The longer they stay here and play the music, the more everybody gets into it.
Summertime's coming, Dad. Summertime's coming.
Look at that fella. Look at that. Uh-oh.
All those posters that you've been seeing in all the windows around town, you might want to look real close at that Pen and Ink Flower Town Festival poster, because somewhere hidden in there it says Go Green Wave.
You told me about that. I found Go Green Wave.
Did you?
Yeah, I found
that. Did you
that.
Find John 3:16?
Didn't find that, and I haven't found the heart yet.
Well, you know, if you find the heart that says P plus S, and you find all three, we'll give you a poster free.
Oh, super.
Come to Town Hall. That's where they're located.
That's going to make me look even harder for it all day. All right, big hand. As the crowd gives a big hand for the vote from the Wave nightclub. Look at that youngster right there. He needs something. He was trying to crawl off the side of the float, I think. Somebody quickly retrieved him. He's enjoying
Children
himself.
Children love
at
the
him.
Parade.
Oh, okay. You can tell. He just wonder what's going through his mind right now.
Oh, he thinks he's big stuff.
All right.
This is the youth ministry. Youth clowning ministry we just saw there.
Here's a vehicle with the sign Mothers Against Drunk Driving. Boy, I strongly support that. I really do. And the Cub Scouts from Cub Scout Pack 711.
Well, they got some flowers on that truck, don't they?
Lots of pretty flowers on there. All right.
They're yelling, turn it up, turn it up.
Here is a Starship. I guess you'd call it. Looks like a Starship from
Hot 94
Radio. And the hot colors down there. Well, that's like something futuristic from out of space, doesn't it?
It really does.
A lot of the media represented here in the Flower Town Festival Parade this year.
It's a good chance for a lot of exposure with so many people being here. Well, I think everybody that has helped has just been glad that they have been able to get in on the ground floor and get the kind of exposure that you get at a festival like this.
Not only everybody is there comes. A tremendous crowd here along the parade route for this festival parade this morning, but believe you me, the park right after the parade, that park is going to fill up with people. It is absolutely going to be jam-packed down there. And the azaleas, everybody thought the azaleas wouldn't be exactly ready, but they are still in bloom. Here's a float from the Knights of Columbus.
Who's that? Who's that guy?
I can't recognize him from here. I don't have a name.
Is he the knight?
He must be the chief knight, wouldn't you think?
And that's a boat?
And that is supposed to be a boat from the Knights of Columbus.
Christopher Columbus.
Well, that's Christopher Columbus. Oh, yeah, well, that makes sense. Yeah.
He sailed into Charleston.
Well, I'll tell you, with all the wind that's been blowing this morning, it probably just blew into Somerville.
That's true. Now, this is where you go before summer
the
comes.
The sun tannery. Now, why would I go to
the
sun?
Well, you know, you just go and you lay down in one of these little beds and it tans you all over.
Oh, okay, all right. Well, they're doing exactly what I like to do. Look at that little youngster right there. He's not even paying attention right now. There he is. Good. He is having himself a ball this morning. And here come the Woodman Rangers. This float is sponsored by the Woodman of the World Fraternal Society with the youth of the Woodman of the World.
They're Youth Lodge of the members. 1295.
Right. They've all got beautiful balloons. I say, I'll say, that's where I ought to be this afternoon.
That's the sun tannery.
Yes, well,
we don't
if not at the
today.
Sun tannery, I need to take that and put it on the lake and just kind of sit out there and relax on a lake somewhere. Beautiful pontoon boat.
Have you ever been in a sun tanning booth?
I haven't been there.
You don't need to go, do you?
No, I probably do. I probably do, yeah. I could always use a little more sun. You just lay there and do nothing?
It's pretty relaxing.
Well, that's my kind of life.
You just relax and it tans you.
That's my kind of life.
Because getting a tan's hard work, Dan.
Oh, yeah, man. I used to lay out there on the beach for hours on hours. It was terrible. It was terrible. By the way, that's Pee Wee Boger. You know Pee Wee Boger?
I've heard of him.
Pee Wee Boger is going, I believe it's next month, going to be fighting for the middleweight world championship.
Boy.
And right here in Charleston.
You don't
right
want to
here
get
Charleston.
Him mad.
No, sir. I had lunch with Pee Wee and his father, Sam Boger, here a couple of weeks back. And let me tell you,
is he a nice guy?
He's a nice guy.
Is he gentle?
He's gentle, but I wouldn't want to make him mad. Let's put it that way. Yes, sir. I would not want to make him mad. By no means at all. You ride horses?
I love horses. I love horses.
I like horses. Horses don't seem to like me too much is the only problem.
It's probably because you try to lead them with force. You've got to lead them with, you got to outsmart them.
Hey, look at these coming here now. And this next, look at all the beautiful azaleas on this float.
Aww.
The Quincy Steakhouse. This all is from Somerville Speedway. And I see up there on the front of that float with all the balloons around her, that is Beth Worthy. She's from right here in Somerville. And she is Miss Southern 500. She was crowned Miss Southern 500 up at Darlington, South Carolina last year. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. From Somerville Speedway. By the way,
the azalea.
I met Ed Beckley here a couple of days ago. We interviewed him, and let me tell you, this is one big fellow.
He weighs 326.
He weighs 326 pounds, and the bike that he rides, the Harley bike that he rides, weighs 270 pounds or 260.
There
in other words, he weighs about 60 more pounds than the bike, and they tell me he's going to be jumping about 10, 11, or 12 cars out there at the Speedway, all part of a Azalea Festival 200 at Somerville Speedway. They do that every year out there at the Speedway, and a lot of great racing excitement out there. If you're in town for the festival, you'll thoroughly enjoy it at Azalea Festival 200 out at Somerville Speedway. Kind of caps off the festival out there with all of the excitement. And then, of course, on Sunday, back down in the park again with all of the arts and crafts. So the whole weekend. It's not just the parade, is it, Sonny? It's the whole weekend. It's just excitement after excitement, throngs of people, fun. It is quite a weekend, probably the biggest weekend in Somerville all year long, wouldn't you say?
Yes, absolutely.
Well, the parade is continuing. We're getting fairly close to the end, but it is continuing. You'll see down there now some of the, I think just out of your picture to the left is a little roadster that just went by, and some beautiful cars back in behind it back there. And I believe I see some horses back there toward the back. We are just about nearing the conclusion of this parade. And Sonny, as it's winding down, let me just say, I think this has been one of the best parades that I've ever seen for the Flower Town Festival.
It really was a good one, wasn't it? I think it has to do with,
that hot rod's turning up down there.
Gosh.
Boy, that is quite a hot, that is an honest to goodness hot rod,
sure
I
is,
believe.
It isn't it?
Absolutely.
Well, you know, we had a lot of quality control this year, so I think that has to do with the quality that you've seen in the parade today.
Well, it has been a high-quality parade, and I'll tell you, my hat's off to everyone involved with putting this parade together this year. Ricky Waring, the chairman of the festival
YMCA,
parade,
the
YMCA,
the
police department, town of Somerville. It's just been
First National Bank.
The
whole city.
Just been a great combined effort to put on one super parade here in downtown Somerville for this year, 1988. And the festival, really, I guess you can say with the parade, the festival officially gets underway, doesn't it?
Let's go.
Let's go
see the arts and crafts.
The festival is officially underway in Somerville. The arts and crafts continuing down in the Azalea Park.
150 artists from all over the United States.
I understand there are about, I think Mike told me there were about 16 or 18 states all around the country that had artists representing there down here this year for the Flower Town Festival. And of course, right across from where the arts and crafts booths are set up, they have the Taste of Somerville, and that's where restaurants all around Somerville.
That's where I want to go.
Yeah, I need to be there. Restaurants all around Somerville have all got the food down there in the park. They'll be cooking it up. I think it's for one cover charge. About $5, I think.
No, you buy tickets.
Oh, you buy individual tickets?
Right, 50-cent tickets, and then you go and eat what you want to.
You can sample everything. Right. Get a taste of Somerville.
We have Greek food and continental and Chinese and American and just a taste of Somerville.
Well, that's it. From downtown Somerville, the 1988 Flower Town Festival. Dan Moon, Sonny Pennington. We'll see you.